It's called Death Valley for a reason. The sun beats down on a barren landscape. Tourists from around the world come to see it.
We come from Switzerland.
And to feel it.
Very hot and thirsty.
With an extreme heat wave bringing soaring temps, the draw is irresistible for some. These two are hitting the pavement, literally.
Why do this?
Because we're crazy. We love the heat.
Well, it's a novelty thing. You know, to say we were out in the heat when it was 125 to 130,
yeah.
Run 2 or 3 miles, then we're finished. And
Death Valley local Mike Wood is used to the heat, but when his shoes start melting, it's time to pay attention.
Tell me about these shoes.
my nasty shoes? Well, the ground temperatures here can approach a couple hundred degrees, so you're talking about pretty much boiling the shoes. So everything that kind of holds the shoes together kind of comes apart.
This is the exact spot where nearly a century ago, the world record was taken for a temperature of 134 degrees. With this heat wave, they're expecting temperatures close to 130 degrees. So rangers come out to this spot, the official weather station. They take a look at these thermometers. And yes, this is for history, but it's also a little bit more important.
Heat can hurt. And if I don't take the right temperature, then we may tell them, oh, it's cool enough to go out and hike the sand dunes, or cool enough to go hike Golden Canyon. It is not.
Ranger Jace knows checks and balances.
Let me check the water temperature.
At this unassuming little post is a part of Death Valley.
When we say the temperature was recorded 4 foot off the ground, back in, there it is.
Was that the box from 1913?
I have no idea, but it looks like it's from 1913.
There's a bit of a debate over where the highest temperatures are read. Some say it's right here at the Badwater Basin, which is the lowest point of elevation in the U.S., at 282 feet below sea level. Tori Dunnan, CNN, Death Valley, California.